broadcast on WCW Main Event Live. It is for the World Television Championship. Introducing first the challenger, accompanied by the greatest promoter on the face of the earth, Colonel Robert Parker, along with me, from Minnesota, weighing 248 pounds, the enforcer, Arn Anderson.
I mean, I've said it before, I'll say it again. Arn Anderson knows more ways to break more bones than anybody in the sport of professional wrestling.
He knows more ways to break more rules than anybody in this great sport. That's why he's a winner.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent in this World TV title contest, from Macon, Georgia, weighing 235 pounds, the World Television Champion, Johnny B. Bud.
And the crowd is going wild for Johnny B. Bud, the World Television Champion, the man who defeated Arn Anderson at Starrcade. Arn Anderson, who stepped in for the honky-tonk man, Elvis, evidently couldn't stand the heat, left the kitchen. He's going to go become a school teacher or something.
Well, like it says on the back of Johnny B. Bad, when you're hot, you're hot. And Johnny, remember this, after you're defeated, when you're not, you're not. That's okay. Arn, he's ready.
Oh, yeah, he's ready. Yeah. He's a little too ready. We haven't even had the bell yet. Johnny B. Bad had his back turned to Arn Anderson, which, big mistake.
You just don't do.
You can't do that.
Arn has time to fight. He is ready.
Arn is livid over the loss that he sustained at Starrcade.
Well, it was a fluke as far as I'm concerned. I don't think Johnny B. Bad led in the match. I don't think he was ahead on points. As far as I'm concerned, this man, Arn Anderson, had the whole match for the whole time. He should have been awarded the title.
No, Arn Anderson made two mistakes. One is he stepped into that match unprepared. Oh, man, right across the throat. The second thing is he underestimated Johnny B. Bad, and that is a mistake a lot of athletes have made. You know, you got to watch Johnny B. Bad's right. Forget about his left, because if he throws it, it's over. You're out of there anyway.
Well, that's true, too. But you talk about Arn Anderson not being prepared. This man is always prepared. I still think it was just an off night. You watch. Things are going to go in his favor, and they have
been. Shoulder right to the solar plexus.
Don't waste much time with the ham and eggers, Arn. Stay on that man. Focus.
I want to take this opportunity to congratulate one of my favorite teams in the NFL, the Pittsburgh Steelers. Another big win today on their way to the Super Bowl.
I hope.
Left hand to the side of the head of Johnny B. Bad. Johnny B. Bad now comes back with a sidekick to the midsection. Another sidekick to the midsection by Johnny B. Bad.
Right hand.
Well, this inserting into a bra, and this is exactly what Johnny B. Bad doesn't want. Excellent takeover. Perfectly executed maneuver by Johnny B. Bad.
Well, look at that. He's not sure where he's at. He should have covered Arn Anderson, but he's not ready yet.
He knows where he's at now. Clothesline takes Arn Anderson right over the top rope. Unintentional, to be sure. Arn Anderson, nonetheless, out on the concrete floor. Johnny B. Bad up and over, and this man is running. I mean, he's got moves like a Rolex.
Oh, I know what he's doing. He wants to keep Arn out on the floor. He knows Arn can't beat him out there on that floor. That's where he wants to keep him. But you're not going to do that for long. Believe me, Parker's got a game plan.
Did you hear that? The whole arena vibrated. We are packed to the rafters here once again for WCW Live Interactive on the cutting edge of professional wrestling.
Behind you.
On top of you.
Come on, Arn, do something.
Johnny B. Bad in definite control of this contest. He's got a lot of confidence coming off of that win in Starrcade. Hooks a leg.
Arn's still got a lot left in him. I can tell when he kicks out, if he raises up and sits up, he's got a lot left in him, and that's what he did.
Irish whip coming off the ropes, elbow to the top of the chest. Arn Anderson has no idea where he's at. Johnny B. Bad in excellent condition. Ooh. Definitely in control. Right hand. But again, as I said, watch out for that left hook. It's a left hook that does all the damage.
Oh, yeah.
A little bobbing, a little weaving. George Foreman, another good friend of WCW's, knows all about bobbing and weaving.
And that's just in line at the, to get a double burger. That's just to go from the French fry line to the double cheese line.
Oh, up over the top rope. And Anderson, I'm telling you, once again, has underestimated and underprepared for this match with Johnny B. Badd.
Or is he just playing possum?
Not a chance.
I don't think so either.
Not a chance. Arn Anderson is way too intense of a competitor.
But he's smart enough not to underestimate Johnny B. Badd. You can't. This man's a television champion. You can't go in there thinking like that.
Again, perfectly executed backdrop. Hooks a leg. Got a two count. The only question I have is why Johnny isn't going chest to chest with Arn when he's trying to cover him. Drop kick right on the money.
Oh, he's not real bright.
Again,
that's
cover one, two, and he doesn't have all of his weight across Anderson's chest.
And Anderson still has too much left in him. You can tell that. Takes a lot to beat Arn Anderson. You got to be lucky, because you're just not going to beat him down.
Again, a cover. One, two. And again, Arn Anderson, I mean, this is just reflex. Here's a guy that's been in so many ring wars. It's just instinct.
I mean, they call him in the hotel, and he raises one shoulder overnight. He's constantly moving, this guy.
But again, I have to point out, Johnny B. Badd maintaining control of this match from the very beginning. Drops the elbow on the inside of the thigh.
I know what he's doing. He's trying to pace himself for Arn Anderson. Usually Arn Anderson likes a 25, 30, 45-minute match. He likes to wear you down. Johnny B. Badd went in this match thinking Arn's going to try to take him to that limit. So he's pacing himself right now. You notice he hasn't done none of his aerial moves yet.
I want to say hi to all our great fans in Phoenix, Arizona. We're coming your way January 12th. Veterans Memorial Coliseum, bell time, 7:30. Get your tickets early. It's going to be a great time when WCW comes to Phoenix. Again, that's January 12th. Veterans Memorial Coliseum as Johnny B. Badd continues to work over Arn Anderson. Arn Anderson on the defensive. And that's something that you don't see often with Arn Anderson. He's usually the aggressor. He's usually the one that's in control.
He's in control right now. He knew he was a big fan of WCW as Charles Barkley.
That's right. In fact, we've had him on a couple of WCW broadcasts in the past.
Oh!
Right hand to the midsection. Knee lift.
You know, I'm wondering if you may be right. Could Arn be taking him too lightly? Or is he just setting him up for the kill?
And now Johnny B. Badd, higher risk than ever. Off the top rope. Perfectly executed. Once again, but we've got Colonel Parker. Parker having to get involved.
Parker knows. Don't go after him or Ming will take your head off.
Now, Parker knows his man is in trouble. Johnny B. Badd saw it coming.
Oh!
Heads up maneuver.
He's
left hook. Arn Anderson, see you later.
Puts on the rope.
Oh, give me a break.
Puts on the rope.
It's a good thing that Arn Anderson has Parker at ringside.
Oh, watch this.
Would be too straight for Johnny B. Badd.
Where's Ming? Where is Ming? There he comes.
Oh, no. Now, this is where Johnny B. Badd has got to be careful. He's wrestling three men in there. Arn Anderson, Parker, and Ming. No matter how you look at it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner and new television champion.
I told you.
The enforcer,
I'm not the kind of a guy to say I told you so.
Anderson.
Oh, no.
But they're giving him the gold right now. There he is, Arn Anderson. The new television champion representing WCW.
I did it.
Couldn't happen to a nicer guy.
He stole it.
Doesn't matter how he did it. He did it. Here's Johnny B. Badd coming off that top rope. Good sunset flip. Put the legs over the shoulders, had him. No referee there to count. He was down for 7, 8, 9, at least that many seconds. But look at this. Johnny B. Badd thinks he's got him here. Hooks the wrong leg. Parker handles his investment well, puts the good leg out, and here it is. Nails him. He goes back into the rope. Seems to me just on reflexes, Parker's showing him the right way. Forward. There you go. Come on, ref. 1, 2, and a 3. We get a new TV champion.